Today we want to show you another Sunday supper. I really want to encourage families to start eating more together. And so this summer we're going to be giving you a series of Sunday suppers where you can have easy cooking. I'm not trying to make them complicated, but delicious cooking. And you can gather your family, friends around to have time of fellowship together and really enjoy one another. And what better way to do that than over good food? Today we're going to be cooking roast chicken with lemon and roasted garlic. Roast potato wedges with rosemary, roasted broccoli with Parmesan cheese, and then a very special dessert, lemon curd mousse with fresh berries. Sounds complicated. Each one of these recipes is easy to do, and trust me, if I can do it, you can do it. So we're going to start with the chicken, and what I really encourage people, this is the only kitchen gadget I think you may not have in your kitchen. It's a microplane grater. I really love these things. And you can use these to get zest. If you use a box grater for zesting the lemon, you may need two lemons because you lose a lot when you use a box grater for grating. But I'll just illustrate how easy it is to get it off.
Wow, look at that. You're hardly having to do
anything. And you get this wonderful zest coming off of this. You don't want to take it down too far. And if you can see, I've just taken off just the top, just the yellow part. If you get into the white part, it'll get a little bitter. And what I'm going to do is just take what we've already prepped and you put that into a bowl. You put a couple tablespoons of olive oil. And here's the thyme. And we are ready to dress our bird.
Does that smell wonderful?
Now, you take the chicken, and a lot of people don't know this, but if you put your finger all the way down, you can separate
the skin from the meat.
And when you do that, it really helps it crisp. But what you're doing is you're creating a pocket in the roast chicken all the way around.
And that's where you're going to put the zest in.
You put all that in, so it gets...
So it cooks right down into the
bird. You flavor the meat as opposed to flavoring the skin.
Uh-huh. And then the skin gets nice and crispy.
And then the skin gets crispy because you're using olive oil.
Ooh.
And you get it all around and get enough where you're going to be able to taste the difference. Anything left, just put in the center. And now I got really yucky hands. Anytime you are dealing with raw chicken, you need to be careful that you're not cross-contaminating. And thank you very much. I feel like I'm a doctor.
Yeah, and I'm a scrub nurse.
All right, the next part is you're going to take the lemon that you've already zested, and you're going to quarter it. And it's real simple. Don't worry about the seeds. You don't care about them. I'm trying to make this easy, and then you
just stuffing it.
Stuff it in there to the extent it'll hold it. And you want to take one of these small yellow onions and do the same thing.
Just quartering it, so.
And it's easy to do. And that will flavor and keep the bird moist. Then you put it into a roasting pan and you are now ready to salt it. And then you take a little bit of this and you put that on the outside. And that helps everything get all nice and friendly. And then you take a pepper mill and you pepper it. So you put that in the oven, 425 for 20 minutes. And then you take it out, and you take another onion, and you just slice it like this, real simple. Make sure you don't cut your thumb. But you want these big chunk slices. And then you take these, and you just, once it's been cooked for, again, 20 minutes at 425, you throw these into the bottom of the pan. All you're trying to do is, this is going to end up in your gravy. So you're going to have some nice roasted onions down in there. Make sure they're in there flat. When you're putting the onions in with the chicken after you've roasted it, take a little chicken stock and just pour it around the edges. And you want to add a little liquid, and that'll keep the onions from getting scorched. And then put it back in the oven, take the temperature down. No, take it down to 375.
Okay.
And It couldn't get any easier than that. That's the roasted chicken.
And how long are you leaving it in there for?
Probably another hour at 375. Okay. Total cooking time, hour and 20. Could be an hour and 15. The easiest way to figure out if you see the big part of that thigh, if you prick it there with a fork and it runs clear,
it's
good.
It's done.
All right? Mm. Easy?
Very easy.
Now, the next part is roasted garlic. A lot of people don't understand roasted garlic, don't use it. And it's real simple to get, and you get a whole nother flavor complex when you roast garlic as opposed to fresh garlic. And a lot of the bite goes away. A little salt.
You simply cut the top off of it, right?
Right. A little olive oil drizzled.
That's it.
And put it in the same oven that you're cooking your chicken in.
At the 375.
Yeah, at the 375 or the 425, doesn't matter. You don't want to cook this more than 20 minutes.
Oh, okay.
Now,
awesome.
We are going to see the finished product. What's it going to look like when you get done with it?
Okay. Oh, wow.
That is what it comes out looking.
Wow.
And so you've got crisp skin on top. But the good part is all of that which is underneath, and that is what is going to make your gravy. I'll take this out.
Perfect. Wow.
And it's then take my little roasting rack out.
Through.
Now, this is the beautiful part, and what makes this recipe so easy is you've got all this wonderful sauce, and the onions are just perfect, and they're all nice and wilted. And you want all these little bits. All of that comes out. If you don't have this much liquid, you can always add more chicken stock.
Mm. Can I help you here with this? Are you good?
Yeah, if you can scrape that in there. This is going to become a wonderful flourless gravy, where you first take all those nice roasted juices, all the nice roasted onions. And here is what roasted garlic looks like when you're done. It's got this look and it's real soft.
Uh-huh. Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And so you're not scared of getting dirty. And you just do with the back of your hand like this.
Wow.
Just squeeze it out.
Look at that. And they all pop. It's almost like they just...
They pop out of their skins.
Uh-huh.
Then you take a chef's knife and you finish the job.
Uh-huh.
And you are creating a wonderful garlic paste.
Wow.
Because now, when you eat this, you don't want a big chunk of garlic.
You just want the flavor of it.
You want the flavor of it.
That's great. Look at that.
Chopped garlic made easy.
Yeah, really.
All right, once you've done this, you're going to let the blender do the rest of the work. And so literally, even though it looks like a ton of garlic, it's going to taste fine.
Really?
And now you cover. Be careful with hot liquid in any blender.
Yeah, there you go.
And always do this. Because hot liquid in a blender will expand, and you don't want it to expand all over you. I'm going to use that olive oil bowl. But just to show you how this comes out, and it's already heated, it's already ready to roll.
Small one. I think the small one would be okay.
And that becomes
a like
wonderful
a puree almost.
Gravy. And you can use that now on your chicken, and it will taste wonderful.
Mm, looking good.
Is that easy?
That's very easy.
It's an easy chicken gravy. It's got a lemon flavor to it. It's got a thyme flavor to it, and it's got a garlic flavor to it. You can also use this, if you want, as a dressing for raw vegetables. All right, here's the chicken, how you present it. We've got roasted potato wedges with rosemary, roasted broccoli with Parmesan cheese,
roasted, huh?
And some wonderful fresh cherry tomatoes. Really makes it look festive. These are Amy Reed's specialties, her yeast rolls done in a muffin pan, which are beautiful and really taste good and really easy to do.
Yeah, oh, they do look beautiful.
And one of my favorites is a lemon curd mousse, and that will knock everybody's socks off
really?
And think that you're
berries
wonderful.
Berries are the jewelry of food, yes.
All right, so we're going to put a little garlic gravy on the chicken and have a taste and tell me what you think. You get a wonderful lemon flavor, you get the thyme flavor, you get the garlic flavor, you get the onion, and the proof is in the pudding.
Oh, my word. Y'all need to make this. Whoa.
Is that good?
Oh, it's beyond good.
You ready to go straight
Sunday
to dessert?
Mm-hmm. Don't you know?
I need another spoon.
Can I just take this right out of here like this? Now, this is a lemon zest curd, you said, or...
Lemon juice. You put a little zest in afterwards. And then whipping cream, eggs, sugar, lemon juice. You make the curd. You let it chill. You whip the cream, and you fold the cream in with the lemon curd, and it comes out beautiful.
Can I tell you, your family will run to dinner. And your guests will never leave. This is fabulous. But it's real light. Well, you just carry on. I'm going
you
for
carry
number three.
On. All right, and you carry on, too. And keep in mind, all of these recipes are on CBN.com. All you have to do is log on there, and it'll be available for you to download, and you can experiment this weekend with how to cook this. If you want to vary the recipes, I always like to encourage people to be innovative in how they cook. And keep in mind this wonderful verse from Proverbs, that it's the food of love. Even a dinner of herbs, if it's made with love, is a lot better than a roasted calf made with hatred. Give your family the food of love this weekend, and you'll be amazed at what happens.
They'll love you back.
Okay, Terry and I are going to run away and eat a lot of lemon curd, but we'll be back with more of the 700 Club right after this.